Ова се најдобрите во 2014-та.
Добро дојавте назад во најдобрите во 2014-та. Јас сум вашиот хитмейкер Милан Ризванович. Следува предпоследната 18-та категорија вечерва.
Најдобар нов артист.
Номинирани се Gene Icon. Sam Smith. I don't have Megan Trainor.
Because you know I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, about that bass.
George Ezra.
Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you want me, then all of this will go away.
Најдобар нов артист на годината е Sam Smith.
Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me.
Sam Smith вечерва беше два пати номиниран, а веројатно очекувано ја понесува титулата најдобар нов артист.
Семјуел Фредерик Сем Смит е роден на 19. мај 1992-та. Учествувал во разни театри, бил и член на повеќе джез бендови, а изучувал и джез музика свиреки пијано. Почна да биде препознатлив првично по хитот на Disclosure во 2012-та Леч и во 2013-та година по хитот на Naughty Boy La La La, со кој застанаа и на врвот на сингл листата во UK. Самостојно за прв пат се представи со краток албум со 4 песни, од кој првата беше Safe With Me, втората Nirvana, а тука беше една преубава песна која направи заедно со Disclosure, Nile Rodgers и Jimmy Nape со име Together. Пред тоа го издаде и првиот официјален сингл од деби албумот, темата Lay Me Down, која не помина забележано, но вистинскиот прв хит од неговиот деби албум во форма на сингл беше Money On My Mind во продолжба од февруари 2014-та. Таа песна го искачи до врвот на сингл листата за прв пат самостојно, доби солидна популярност и одлично го представи како успешен соло артист. Деби албумот следуваше кон средината на 2014-та со име In the Lonely Hour, стигнувајќи до врвот на британската албумска листа, а до второто место на албумската листа во Америка. Во Америка тоа е вториот најдобар продаван албум во 2014-та, што за еден британски артист, и тоа нов, е големо достигнување. Вториот сингл од изданието е госпел баладата Stay With Me, со која исто така се искачи на врвната позиција на сингл листата во UK.
Oh, won't you stay with me?
Следуваа уште два синглови, темите I'm Not The Only One, која се искачи до второто место, и Like I Can. Интересно за Смит е тоа што откако со Naughty Boy, со хитот La 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 се искачи на врвот на сингл листата, па до сега, дури 4 пати го има тој успех. Покрај со La 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 и со неговите два хитови Money On My Mind и Stayin' With Me, тој беше на врвот и како учесник во добротворниот хит на Band Aid 30, Do They Know It's Christmas. Во првата година, на сцената 4 број 1 хитови, не се малку. In the Lonely Hour е албум кој, кога ќе го дослушате, ќе сакате да го гушнете, сем бидејќи ќе ве остави со чувство на сожалување за човекот. Тоа се се тажни љубовни песни во кои Сем има исклучителна вокална изведба. Британците го викаат машката Адел, што и има малку основа, но Сем е на вистина крајно потентен вокалист, чија специјалност како да му станаа баладите. Љубовта е мономанија во ова издание. Тоа е едно љубовно писмо упатено кон оној што не ги возвратил чувствата. Една од песните кои се пример за ова е големиот хит Stay With Me. Токму таа песна ја избравме за да одбележиме победата на Сем во категоријата Најдобар нов артист.
Guess it's true, I'm not good at a one-night stand. But I still need love, cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all self-control. Deep down I know this never works, but you can lay with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're
добар нов артист на годината е Сем Смит. Го преслушавме неговиот голем хит Stay With Me од милионски продаваниот деби албум In The Lonely Hour. Во оваа категорија низ годините, 106-ка на вистина се докажа како одличен најавувач и предвестник на новите артисти. Во 2001-та победија Горилас, 2002-та Шакира, а натаму Шон Пол, Maroon 5, James Blunt, Arctic Monkeys, Simian Mobile Disco, Duffy, Lady Gaga, Hurts, Lick Ellie, Psy и Macklemore и Ryan Lewis во минатата година. Само во 2012-та година ми е сумљиво прогласувањето на Сај за најдобар нов артист, но во сите останати години на вистина сме направиле одличен избор, бидејќи сите победници сега се големи музички звезди.
Ова се најдобрите во 2014-та.
Шоуто продолжува со уште гости. Со нас се Сија и Тейлор Свифт. Сија, ти избегнуваш да се појавуваш во јавност, не сакаш да се појавиш во спотовите, едноставно не сакаш да си популярна, така?
I don't want to be famous or recognizable. I don't want to be critiqued about the way that I look on the internet. I was at Target the other day buying a hose and nobody recognized me and my song was on the radio and I thought, okay, this experiment is working.
Која е причината за толкавата приватност?
I've been writing pop songs for pop stars now for a couple years and have become, you know, friends with them and see what their life is like and that's just not something I want.
Сија, ти во 2010-та имаше проблеми со алкохолот и со прекомерната употреба на лекови, дури стигна и до обид за самоубиство, но од тогаш до сега гледаме сосема спротивна личност, успешна и фалена. Како гледаш на тој период во твојот живот?
I do spend a lot of time like pinching myself. I have to say it's been pretty amazing. Oh, I might cry. It's been really amazing. The last couple of years have just been since I made the decision to just take care of my own sanity and serenity and stuff. My life's just improved so much and I'm honestly surprised.
Ти благодарам сија, Тейлор Свифт. Повторно си на врвот на топ листите, повторно имаш number one изданија, како и со секое твое ново изданије и повторно со големи хитови од албумот 1989. Што конкретно со оваа последна музичка колекција сакаше да постигнеш како артист?
I wanted to change things up sonically. I wanted to keep the lyrics and the things that I know my fans are very attached to intact and, you know, stick with the idea of writing confessionally and writing kind of zinger lines, like lines they can quote and, you know, catchphrases. I wanted to stick with that, but then again, I wanted to switch up what you heard underneath it. I wanted to switch up the primary instruments you're hearing and change that entire landscape, and that's what I'm very proud of on this record.
И сега милиони луѓе ги мрдаат колковите во ритамот на Shake It Off.
That's all I've ever wanted. I'm so excited because my friend Ed Sheeran texted me last night and he's like, I'm in a club at 3 in the morning and I've heard Shake It Off 3 different times. I've been here for 2 hours. And I was just like, you know, that's my dream. That's all I've ever wanted is for people to dance to one of my songs, because usually people just cry to my songs.
А и песната звучи навистина поинако од твоите досегашни теми. Која беше твојата идеја со неа?
That song was something I legitimately wrote as a joke. It was like I sat down and I thought, I was kind of having one of those days where I was a little frustrated by the fact that the media has kind of fictionalized my personal life to this cartoon extent, where it's like they've painted this picture of a girl who's like able to like get all these guys, she's a serial dater, but then, and they like jet set around the world, and then she goes crazy and becomes clingy and needy and desperate, and then she like scares them off, and then they come back, but then they leave her again, and then she's left broken, and then she's scornful. It's like this whole profile of a, you know, over emotional, crazy, fragile, like starlet thing. And I thought that was actually kind of interesting and hilarious, and so I wrote a song from the perspective of what she would actually say in a song if I was her. And what's fun about music is that, you know, things that you can write kind of as a joke, a little bit like with a little humor in them, most people get it. Like most people get that, like Shake It Off is a funny, like I'm not actually rapping seriously in that song. Like, but some people are like, oh my God, why is she trying to be a rapper? Like, don't get it.
Мислам дека и со видеото одлично го представи не само песната, ами и албумот. Колку ти имаш улога во тој визуелен дел од кариерата?
I like to kind of be very visual with things. Like after I write a song, I can tell exactly usually how I want to perform it on an award show or during the tour, and most of the time I get an idea for the video. The Shake It Off video was an idea I had immediately after I wrote the song. So what I'll do is I'll get the idea and then I'll scour the internet for my opinion of the right director and reach out to them and say, hey, here's this new song, here's my idea for it, what do you think? And then they'll kind of elaborate on their contribution to it, like if they agree with it. So it's a really fun process, and I'm having a blast making videos for this new record. We've kind of gotten the jump on it. We've been doing it early.
Ти благодарам, беа тоа Taylor Swift и Sia во најдобрите во 2014-та. Почитувани слушатели, стигнуваме до последната категорија во најдобрите во 2014-та. Веќе ви беше најавено дека во категоријата специјално признание за животно дело победуваат Simply Red. Англиски поп-бенд кој досега продал над 50 милиони албуми, бенд кој за следната година најави реоформување со специјален концерт за одбележување на нивната 30 годишнина од постоењето на светската музичка сцена. Имаат 10 студиски албуми, 4 компилации, 1 краток албум и 45 синглови. Сите ги знаете нивните големи хитови: Money's Too Tight to Mention, Holding Back the Years, It's Only Love, If You Don't Know Me By Now, A New Flame, Something Got Me Started, Stars, For Your Babies, Fairground, Remembering the First Time, Night Nurse, Say You Love Me, Mellow My Mind, Sunrise, Fake и многу други. Yes, I give it all up for you. Yes, I give it all up for you. Yes, I give it all up for you. Пракса е во последните неколку години во најдобрите во 2014-та, да не ја раскажуваме ние целата приказна за бендот, бидејќи многу поинтересно е кога самите членови или самите артисти победници ја раскажуваат својата историја, односно се осврнуваат и се подсетуваат на најбитните моменти од кариерата. Така ќе биде и вечерва, нема јас да раскажувам, туку Мик Хакнел.
I've always likened the music to diaries. They're kind of where you are at the moment in time in your career. Starting out with Money's Too Tight to Mention, it was a cover. And the Valentine Brothers that I used to DJ their version, never had a major hit with it. I think it just scraped the top 40. And we thought this was a great song. And it had particular relevance to the era because it was very much kind of like the Reagan-Thatcher era. And the same kind of political and financial ideas, drip-down economics, that whole kind of thing they shared together. I'd just come from living in Moss Side in Manchester for 4 years. I'd been unemployed for 4 years. And, you know, I was pretty at the bottom of the pack, really. And then all of a sudden, we had this hit record, and it happened very, very quickly. And I kind of blinked, and then I was standing on stage in Los Angeles at the Grammy Awards. And it just all seemed so quick, and it was really hard for a northern working class boy to sort of come to terms with such a dramatic change in one's life. I think it took me about 10 years to even get used to it. It's funny, in the beginning of your career position is very, very tenuous, for being a one-hit wonder to having this long-term career. Holding back these, thinking of the fear I've had so long. We released Holding Back the Years in the UK, and it didn't even make the top 40 in the UK. So we were having success in Europe, in Italy, in Germany, and also in the States. And it wasn't until the success of Holding Back the Years in America that it rebounded in America, was reissued, and then made it to number two in the charts. So that was when we became, how do you say, slightly more established within the sort of UK psyche. You think, well, if you're number one in America, you're on top of the world. And that's it. It's like, I felt like Jimmy Cagney on the top of the, I'm top of the world, Ma! You know, it just was magnificent. I'll keep holding on. I'll keep holding on. I'll keep holding on. I'll keep. I met all these incredible sort of stars and just was just living it up, you know. When I was an art student, I became a huge fan of Jack Nicholson in these early movies, Five Easy Pieces and this kind of stuff, The Last Detail. And so Jack Nicholson came to one of the shows, and I saw him he was dancing on a table at the back of this tiny gig with his shades on in the pitch dark. What's he doing with his shades on? You go, well, it's Jack Nicholson, you know. And he invited us for a drink after the show, and he just finished making that movie Terms of Endearment. And I'm standing there, I'm thinking, I'm standing next to Jack Nicholson here. This is completely insane. It's like, you want to pinch yourself because you just can't believe it. And that whole era was kind of like that, you know, with being in America. It wasn't real. It means a huge amount to me to have success in Black America, because that's my predominant musical influence. And to work with people like Lamont Dozier and meet Al Green and Stevie Wonder and all these people was an incredible thrill.
Tomorrow night, I wanna treat you right. By the time we came to do A New Flame, we decided this time to record in Montserrat in the Caribbean, which was a very rock star. I also began the first kind of decent relationship, actually, around that time. I'd met a girl in Japan, an American girl, and we started seeing each other quite regularly as you could in the job that we were both in. She was a model and I was a musician, but we'd meet all places all over the world, and New Flame, the song, was really dedicated to her. I was quite proud of that song because it was an original song, and I was getting a lot of heat as just being a bit of a covers artist, because we had If You Don't Know Me By Now on A New Flame, as well as the Barry White song It's Only Love, and they were both hits for us. So to then get a hit with A New Flame as well just made me feel a whole lot better about my songwriting. The original by Harold Melvin is a real production affair, you know, strings in it and horns in it. There's everything in the kitchen sinks in that song. And what we wanted to do was do an almost jazz version of If You Don't Know Me By Now by stripping it down to guitar, piano, bass and drums and vocals. And that's exactly what it was. And it worked because it was a great song.
It should be so easy to do.
I'm still very proud of that version. We had a number one with it in America. The second one, which was just a dream, and it was a hit all over the world.
What good is a love affair when you can't see eye to eye? Oh.
Well, this was an interesting time because this was the first beginnings of a real musical division between me and the band. Because with A New Flame, I had a nose for commerciality. You know, I wanted to have success. Right from the beginning, I so wanted to be in a band. I so wanted to be, you know, the next Beatles or the next Rolling Stones or something like that. So I held on to that so preciously and dug it for so long and tried to just delude myself that that was the case. But the truth of it, there was no other songwriter in the band. No member of the band ever wrote a hit song inside that band. And I was deluding myself. You can imagine at the height of the Beatles' success, they had each other, you know. They might have been locked away in hotel rooms, but the four of them were locked away in a hotel room. I was locked in a hotel room on my own, or usually with a few girls, but that's another story. But not as a team, you against the world, you know. So that makes you very, very insecure and strange and you know, quite lonesome in a way.
I give it all up for you. 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 I give it all up for you.
Yes,
I give it all up for you.
Yes,
I give it all up for you.
Yes,
I give it all up for you.
Yes, I would.
I think I was probably at my peak as a songwriter within that whole shenanigan of pop success and everything. You know, I'd been sort of wound up by this covers issue, and I decided to set myself a goal and just write an entire album. That's how we ended up with Stars. I wrote most of the Stars album on the road, actually, on a lot of time on aeroplanes with a Walkman and a bit of paper. And whenever we had like a week off or 2 weeks off, I'd amass all the lyrics that I'd gather up through being on the road and then just start trying to work on songs then. So we did the demos for them in Manchester. And when you come home, you really just want to be home. You know, I used to dream about making a really good curry and just staying home, watching the TV, watching a movie, listening to some records and just staying home. And that was really like a kind of a fantasy at one point. Oh, I can't wait to get home.
Stay a minute, can't you see that
I was searching for female approval. So I was trying to seduce as many women as I possibly could get my hands on from the time I started out. That was all that really drove me, incredibly. And I didn't really make any friendships with other men or with anything, because I was so busy chasing women. It was like some kind of psychological obsession. And I think of it now as being like this fundamental basic insecurity of wanting to get as much love as possible from the opposite sex, to sort of like kind of prove that somebody loved you, to prove that, you know, somebody cared, you know, that kind of thing. There's little giveaway lines that when I wrote them, they were written subconsciously, but I look back now in the chorus line of Something Got Me Started, I'd give it all up for you. Or in the line of Stars, I want to fall from the stars straight into your arms. It's basically saying, I want to give up. I want to stop this and actually find somebody. I didn't know I was saying it at the time, but you can hear that in the music now. So there were little sorts of cries for help hidden in this kind of catchy tunes.
When our love was good, it was all that we saw. When our love was good, it blinded us before this real revolution, baby, where you're not below me anymore.
Never, never love you.
Never be enough.
Never be enough.
Just ain't good enough, yeah.
With Stars, we'd had 5 top 20 hits, which for many albums is quite an achievement, and that kept us going for 2 years, 2.5 years. That album wouldn't go away, so it was a very difficult album to follow, you know. But we still managed to get 4 top 20 hits off the live album as well, which people forget. And the biggest one being Fairground, which was my first UK number one. And my view then was about bloody time, you know, goodness me, I've been doing it for long enough. I finally get a number one single, and it was a real thrill because the album and the single were both number one at the same time. And I thought, well, that's it now. I think I've done enough. And so it was quite easy for me after life to just kind of put a stop to it and just say, time to do something else now.
And I love the thought of coming home to you, even if I know we can make it.
Between 1994 and 1996, where did it go? What was I doing for those 2 years? I have absolutely no idea what I was doing during that time. I made an album. I remember making an album, but I can't remember anything else, really. It's so strange.
Remembering the first time we made love, I was just recalling.
Andy Wright, who I'd started work with on Fairground, he came up with the idea of the Hall & Oates sample. And as soon as I heard it, I just thought, this is going to be great. And the rest is history, as they say. Well, it actually brought our music to a new generation, you know. We started to get a younger crowd in after that song, and it felt quite good about that. We, you know, here we are, we've set up our own label, and we managed to make it work. I was still sort of going out and getting drunk 2 nights a week, just existing, really, you know, living for my work. And then the rest of the time just getting mashed up. And I gained a lot of weight because of the partying and stuff. And then I just got into this rhythm of just getting messed up all the time and waking up with someone I didn't even know. And, you know, just living what maybe a teenage boy would think would be an ideal rock and roll lifestyle, but it wasn't. It just wasn't making me very happy. And I found myself going deeper and deeper into a hole that I didn't want to be in, and I just needed to get out of it, you know, and I didn't really get out of it until sort of 2000, between 2003, 2005. Try and leave a legacy of strong melody and lyrics that mean something to somebody, that they can hear it and it actually affects them in their lives or makes them think about what they're doing in their lives and strikes a chord with them in that way. And I just hope that will be the case and that people can come back to these songs in years to come and it would still kind of get somebody in the right way and go, that's how I feel about my kids, or that's how it is for me in my relationship right now. So that's what I really try and achieve.
Мик Хакнал се подсети и ви раскажуваше за некои од најбитните моменти во кариерата на неговиот 30 години стар бенд Simply Red, на кој вечерва му оддаваме специјално признание за животно дело во најдобрите во 2014-та. Правиме место за нивните два големи хитови Money's Too Tight to Mention и Something Got Me Started.
Look out! It's coming! So I went to the bank to see what they could do. They said, son, look like that luck got a hold on you.
Money's too tight to mention.
Oh, money, 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 money.
Money's too tight to mention.
I can't even qualify for my pension. I went to my brother to see what he could do. He said, brother, I'd like to help you, but I'm unable to. So I called on my father, father, almighty father. What'd he say?
Money's too tight to mention.
That's what he said to me right now. Yes, it is.
Money's too tight to mention.
Sure. mention. Oh, yes it is, yes it is, yes it is. Hey now,
first you'd like to mention.
I'm talking about dinero.
Yes, I
give it all up for you.
Yes, I would.
I give it up.
Yes, I would.
Почитувани слушатели, во категоријата специјално признание за животно дело, вечерва почитно даваме на Simply Red. Ги преслушавме нивните два големи хитови, Money's Too Tight to Mention и Something Got Me Started, а приказната за Simply Red, односно за некои од најбитните моменти во нивната кариера, ви ја презентираше нивниот лидер Мик Хакнел. Во ово шоу, до сега, специјално признание за животно дело му отдадовме на Майкл Джексон, Мадонна, U2, Принц, Депеш Мод, Стиви Вондер, Боб Дилан, Ролинг Стоунс, Ред Хот Чили Пеперс, Брус Спрингстин, Шаде, Бон Джови и Пол Маккартни. Пред сосема да го одјавам вечерашното големо шоу, уште еднаш да се подсетиме на сите победници во сите категории. Најдобра R&B песна е The Worst на Джене Айко. Најдобра денс песна е Hideaway на Кајза. Најдобра хип-хоп песна е Turn Down For What на DJ Snake и Lil Jon. Најдобар машки артист е Фарел Вилиамс. Најдобар женски артист Кейти Пери. Најдобар ремикс на песна Робин Шулц ремикс на хитот Prayer and See на Lily Wood and the Prick. Песна на годината според 106-ка Enrique Iglesias Bailando. Најдобар албум Multiply на Ed Sheeran. Најдобар американски сингл е Taylor Swift со Shake It Off, а британски Ed Sheeran со Sing. Најдобра рок песна е Magic на Cold Play. Најдобра поп песна е Happy на Фарел Вилиамс. Најдобра саундтрак песна е I See Fire на Ed Sheeran. Најдобра група е Coldplay. Најдобра соработка е Dangerous на David Guetta и Sam Martin. Песна на годината според слушателите на 106-ка Enrique Iglesias со Bailando. Продуценти на годината се Coldplay, Paul Epworth, Daniel Green и Rick Simpson. Најдобар нов артист е Sam Smith и специјално признание за животно дело му дадовме на Simply Red. Овде е самиот крај на најдобрите во 2014-та, најголемото радио шоу во Македонија, во чија реализација учествуваше целиот 106-ка тим, а шоу низ кое бе водев јас, вашиот хитмейкер Милан Ризванович. Ми остана само да ви ветам следна средба во ово големо шоу за точно 365 дена, на крајот од новата година, во која ви посакувам да имате здравје, среќа и многу дружења со нови содржини на вашиот музички лидер, и ви посакувам никогаш да не бидете без музика. За крај на шоуто ке свират Sigma и Paloma Faith со Changing. Чао, чао, бај, бај!
Everything is changing. Time for me to come play.
Everything is changing. And I've been here for too long. Going through the same thing. I've been hurting down long.
We got to move on.
Say, I can't do this anymore. Everything is changing.
We're tired of this.
People now.